Hello everyone, in this tutorial we'll see how to blur a background of an image in a professional way using Photoshop Beta. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's jump to Photoshop Beta. Then let's open the image that we'll be using. And as you can see, this image, it doesn't have a blurred background. Maybe that was the intention, not to blur the background. But for this tutorial, we're gonna see how to blur the background using Photoshop Beta in a very good professional way. All right, so the first thing that we're gonna do is to make a selection. So let's switch to the quick selection mode. And then in this select subject in here, we're gonna drop down and choose cloud instead of device. This will actually make a much better job to make a selection. So I'm just gonna one click on select subjects and see. All right, as you can see, we have a really nice, decent selection. I mean, we still need to improve it a little bit more. For example, I want to include this. So let's actually switch to the lasso tool, and by pressing shift I can add to the selection, and by pressing alt I can remove from the selection, for example from here. Alright, and maybe remove this part too. I want to add this chain in here, but I think I will do it using a brush when we are having a layer mask. So let's see if we have other stuff to remove or to add. Yeah, this one I will add it to the selection, and I think I'm happy with this. Now I will one click on select and mask to try to refine this a little bit more. For example, I can try to refine this in here using the refine mask. It's a little bit to see. I think it's okay. And in this part too. And a little bit in the hairs. I mean, the key to have a very nice background or blurred background in Photoshop is to have a really nice selection. So this way it will make it look very professional when you have a nice selection. Alright, so I think I'm happy with this. Now we'll add some adjustments in here. For example, the radius, I will put it to 3 pixels. And I will smooth out the selection a little bit to 7. And maybe I will shift the edges a little bit to like minus 8. And I will press OK. Alright, now we're gonna make a copy of the background. So I'm just gonna drag this to this new layer icon, and let's call this subjects. Alright, and then I will one click on this layer mask to add the selection to the layer mask. And as you can see, we have in here our selection, but let's add this chain because I think it would add a really nice details to the whole image. So I have the hardness set to 87% with 100% opacity of the brush, and I will try to add this chain to our image in here. Try to do it quickly. Alright, I think we have a really nice selection in overall. I'm happy with this. Now we need to actually remove this couple in here and have the background stand out alone without anything in here, so we can blur it and it looks very professional. And to do that, we're gonna use the generative fill in here. But first we need to load the selection again by going to the our subject layer and then pressing Ctrl or Command and one click on the layer mask, and this will load the selection. Now using the same generative fill bar, we can actually access the expand selection from this icon in here. You can access this. So I'm just gonna click on it and choose 50 pixels for the expanding the selection. And this way it will actually allow us to remove any contents that we don't want. For this case, we will remove this. So let's switch to the lasso tool first and add this to the selection. All right, now we're gonna create another copy of the background, so we'll have the original just in case. And let's call this BG for background. All right, now we're gonna one click on generative fill, and we don't have to type anything in here, so I'm gonna click generate and wait for it to generate. All right, as you can see, we removed the background, but you can see it's because we still have the subjects on top. So in here we can see the variation. This is very nice. This one also, it's nice. I think this one is pretty cool, and this one not that much. But let's try this while the couple are standing to see. So we're gonna switch between them, the three variation, and you know, you can generate more if you want. But I think I'm happy with the first and the second one. So I think I will go with the first one. Yeah, I think I will go with this one. All right, now we need to merge these generative layers that we created with the original background that we have in here. So we're gonna select it and then press Control or Command and select the generative layer. And then I'm gonna press Control Command E to merge the two layers together, and let's call it new BG for background. All right, so we're almost done. Now we only need to add the blur to our background. As you can see, we successfully separated the both subjects and the background. So now we can add the blur. But for me, I always like to use the blur galleries, or the, in this one in here, I like to use the tilt shift. And also the cool thing about it is it allows you to use it while you are using the smart objects. So first let's right click and choose convert to smart objects for this new background that we created. And then let's go to filter, blur gallery, and choose tilt shift. All right, now in here, I don't want to actually blur the part of the face because it doesn't work like that. So this one, I want to keep it without any blur. So I will put it just right here. And then you can add the margin that you want from the blur to show. So let's add actually the blur to see how it looks like. I think it looks really nice. So let's go actually exaggerate a little bit to like 70, 73 for the blur. Then let's drop down this a little bit for us to have a really nice gradient of the blur. Something like this. And this one I will put it up, and this one a little bit down, to have this blurred too. All right, so I think it looks really nice, but I also want to add some bokeh to the blur because this is a perfect scenario or a perfect scene because we have a lot of lights and colors. So we're gonna add the bokeh in here. So to do that, you can see in here we have effect. So the first thing I'm gonna do is to add the light of the bokeh for like 30 or 40 in here. I know it doesn't look that much, but we're gonna fix this. And as you can see, it looks very white. And the second, we're gonna add some colors so we won't see only white. And now in the light range, we don't want to be that white, so we're gonna put the black a little bit up, and this will fix our problem. So let's put it around 240. And as you can see, we will have really nice bokeh in the image in here. It looks amazing. But I think I want to put this more down actually, and maybe add more blur for us to have this really nice bokeh in the background. I think I'm really happy with this, and I hope that you like this one too. So let's actually adjust it a little bit more. Alright, I think I'm good with that, and I will press OK. Alright, as you can see, we have our background that is blurred in a really nice way. But let's actually make it more realistic, because as you can see, the feet in here, I don't like how they look like. So to do that, we can just use the same background that we left in here, not touch. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J to make a copy of it, and then I will drag it to the top, and then I'm gonna apply a black layer mask by pressing Alt or Option and one click on this layer mask icon, and using a brush. This time I will make the hardness like 0%, and also the opacity I will put it down to like 50. Now we can bring back from the original image to the image that we just blurred. For example, all the shadows that we want to bring back, we can do that. And let's take this a little bit down. You know, stuff like that to make the image look more realistic and interesting. Alright, all the places that they are not blurred, we can actually take them back to their original state. And as you can see, this chain, it looks amazing because of the blurred background. So I think they look really nice. All right, one other thing that you can do to make the image look more professional is actually to create a new layer on top of the subject that we made the selection, the subject layer. We're gonna make a new layer on top, and let's call it blur. Now we're gonna actually clip it to the subject layer by pressing Alt or Option, and as you can see, when we do that, we're gonna have this down arrow. So one click, and this will clip it to the subject layer. After that, we're gonna go and choose blur tool, and the strength is set to 100%, and also make sure that sample all layers is checked, and go to the edges of the image and start blurring in here a little bit to give that feeling that, you know, the images belong to the background, because we have a blurred background, so the edges, it should be a little bit blurred too. So that's the trick for it to look very nice and professional, and you don't have to worry about how strong the blur you are brushing with, because we can always drop down the opacity. So I will do this for all the edges. Alright, as you can see, it looks really nice. And of course, you can always take down the opacity to like 70%. And now let's see the before and after. So let's group all in here that we change. And then let's see before and after. It looks really nice and very professional with the bokeh and everything. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this quick tutorial, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.